This episode of Modern Rogue is brought to you by Squarespace.
Go to squarespace.com. Oh, damn it. Sorry. It's perfect.
I got intense there for a bit. I was like, it's harder than I thought. It's harder than I thought.
The Modern Rogue cooks with Thermite.
I'd say this is a fairly traditional American cookout, right? We got steaks, we got seasonings, we have rust, powdered aluminum.
I think this could be a horrible disaster.
I think you're right.
I'm very excited.
We have two fire extinguishers, we have a bag of sand, and we all can run really, really fast. So there's a bunch of different types of thermite, but the most common one uses rust and aluminum powder. But not just any aluminum powder, it has to be of a certain fine-grained mesh. And then once the reaction starts, it self-oxidizes, right?
Correct. The rust is the oxidizing agent, I
think? That's right, that's right. Because the end result is you get aluminum oxide, you get iron, and you get heat. And in fact, like imagine you have a block of iron, it turns into rust. This reaction just takes out the oxygen and makes it back into iron.
Yes, and we're basically making just a bunch of molten metal.
How do we harness this energy for the incredibly frivolous purpose of cooking these steaks?
Well, first, let's make some thermite.
There's a bunch of different recipes, and each one will have a different reaction, but the one I learned is that it's 3 parts by weight of aluminum powder to 8 parts of iron oxide. In this case, it just happened that we have 3 pounds and 5 pounds. So we have exactly 8 pounds of iron oxide. Now we just need 3 pounds of aluminum. So this is 5 pounds of fine mesh aluminum. I figure if we just take out 2 pounds, then we mix them all together and we're good?
I think so, yeah.
All right, by doing bigger quantities, the rounding errors kind of blend out there.
Right.
Because it's finicky stuff. When we've tried to do it before, there's been times it just wouldn't ignite. There we go. Well, we took out 2 pounds, so this is 3 pounds of aluminum powder.
Yeah.
And then we got 8 pounds of iron oxide. What do we want to mix this in, do
you think? You should get a box.
Okay, we're gonna mix all these. We really should have respirators. Just don't breathe. All right, so at this point we just mix.
Oh, hey, right on.
Hey, yeah, remember we made these.
Yeah, actually. Probably the best way to do this is to get it in a closed bag and just shake it up like crazy. I remember once when we made 60 pounds of this stuff, we put it in a box and just kicked it down a hill.
Yeah.
And so the idea is once the reaction's hot enough, it begins to self-oxidize as it bonds the elements together. But the problem is, how do you stop it once it starts, right? And most of the time when you use a fire extinguisher, it robs it of oxygen and stops the flame. But since it has its own oxygen, it won't stop, but you can possibly cool everything down enough that the reaction stops happening.
Okay.
Because that's the thing, is this is extremely stable. It's very difficult to get started. Once it gets started though, it's very difficult to stop.
Wanna give it a try?
Yeah, you gonna test it first?
Yeah.
I'm gonna be honest with you, these masks will offer little to no protection, but they look kind of cool.
At least they won't blind you.
Oh, there's that.
If we mixed it correctly, if we have the right ratios, all we need is enough heat to start the reaction, but you need way hotter. Like, look at this. You can even take this flame and nothing really happens there. You need something with a little more kick, so we got magnesium strips. This is test one. See if we got the recipe right. Yeah! Huh. I don't think we got the recipe right.
I don't think we did.
Okay, all right, so we'll add a little bit more aluminum. All right, take two.
Hey!
Now we're talking. Holy cow! Oh, this is gonna be great.
Outstanding.
Dude, that was gorgeous.
I made the mistake of looking at it without the welding protection.
You're Egon, you're like, I looked into the trap ray.
So that mixture right now is a mixture of aluminum oxide and iron. Basically, we've reconstituted the iron that originally rusted to form the iron oxide. So now the question is,
how do we cook this?
How do we cook a steak? Oh man, that stays hot.
It is glowing.
This one will be a little bit bigger. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get some gloves and I'll actually hold the pan over it like I'm frying over a campfire.
Are you kidding me?
No, 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 I think it'll work.
Okay. This is ill-advised. I like it.
Throw on a little bit of whoosh. Pour a little touch of vegetable oil.
A little dab?
Yeah.
These are not sanitary conditions, but I've seen you eat pizza off the street,
okay,
so.
Okay, that did not end well and you know it.
Garlic?
Yeah. I'll let you do the honors, sir. Here it goes, here it goes, here it goes. Come on, baby. No.
No, need a little more aluminum. Try this again.
One steak coming up. And keep on it. There you go.
All right.
Yeah, once it starts. Okay, so.
Oh, God, that's bright.
Yeah, it's hot.
Oh, you can feel the heat.
Yeah, I can feel the heat. It's hot. It's very hot. Okay. Okay. So hot. It's melting.
Is it melting the plate?
The gloves. Should have worn the other gloves. All right, we're good. We're good. Oh my God. It's gorgeous.
Is it cooking the steak?
The steak is cooking. Oh my God, look, look, look. It's working.
Yeah!
Holy cow!
I did not expect this to work.
Yeah, me neither. Woo! Oh, this is great. I can't believe it.
Holy hell, that is amazing.
I think you're gonna get your medium steak, buddy.
Yeah.
It is really, really hot. Open up that garage door immediately.
Wow!
That was extraordinary!
Super effective!
That was amazing!
Yes!
Well, and what I didn't expect is that it's even better. It's a more even heat that holds on after it stops sparking and glowing.
Oh, and it smells good too.
Oh, dude. My guess is it's gonna be super rare on the inside, but yeah. The outside looks like it's nicely seared.
I'm concerned about its rawness. That makes me a little nervous.
Well, then let's cook it some more. The trick is you gotta do the thermite flash and then let it just ride the residual heat.
Yeah. Wow.
It's starting to look good now. You got that juices bubbling up on top.
Yeah, I'm just concerned about that center there, you know?
I love the fact that we went from, oh golly, it worked, to, well, let's make it as good a steak
as we can.
I mean, if we're gonna eat this thing.
Steak, right?
I say we throw another, just a small flash of the stuff on there.
Okay.
Keep it on there just like you did, keep going. There we go. There we go.
Yeah!
Oh, that's good stuff. Starting to smell real good.
Yeah, it is. Sell Thermite and Thermite cooking accessories.
Taste the rust, it's not a bust.
Partake of our Thermite.
Thermite! How long you been sitting on that one?
Just came up with it just now, right here.
The first ever making of Thermite. This iron slag got heated up to around 4,000 degrees Fahrenheit, and even after the chemical reaction stopped, it retains all that heat and slowly dissipates just by radiating it out, right? It
smells pretty good.
You wanna, dare we try cutting off a slice?
Oh, much better.
That looks perfect. Yes. Would you like to do the honors?
Yeah. Mr. Brushwood?
Yeah?
That is a good steak.
Yeah!
Oh my God, it's great. Look at that.
Look at that.
It's a perfect medium steak. That is good stuff, man. I'm calling off the rest of the shoot. We're just gonna cook and eat steak. Well done, sir. No pun intended.
Yo, man, you see the Modern Rogue remix?
It's gorgeous and terrifying.
Okay, well, gorgeous because it features the two of us. Terrifying because it takes old Modern Rogue episodes and chops them up into complete nonsense. This is our fault, you know. We're the ones who asked for fan tribute sites, and we got it.
Yeah, but I didn't expect him to make the ring video.
It pretty much is. Here, check this out.
Glass.
Okay.
We did this wrong.
You're right.
This is a dumb solution.
It was your idea.
We're gonna be cutting glass.
Okay.
We did this wrong. I love that it's so surreal, and it puts a completely different, usually sinister context to it.
So I'm gonna give him minus points for not having the complete archive of Modern Rogue Remix episodes, but I am gonna give him plus points for using Squarespace, and because I'm sure this took them all of like 3 seconds to put together using one of their templates,
that's why there is no excuse to have a website in 2016 that looks like a garbage fire. Just use Squarespace.
Head on over to squarespace.com/rogue, sign up for a free trial, and when you do sign up, make sure to use promo code ROGUE at checkout. Not only will you get 10% off, but more importantly, you'll be keeping our garbage fire in business. How about that?
Yes, I like it. I didn't even have to shock you that time.
Yeah, okay. So what do we want to feature next? I assume not everybody needs to make remixes.
Let's just get them to send in any cool sites that they've made. I'm sure that our viewers are exceptionally creative, so they've probably built some gorgeous works of art.
Just talking to you guys.
I'm talking to you.
Let's make it happen.
Send it to us.
Yeah.
Let's show it off.
What'd this guy say?
Yes.